This old mining town in Norway is sitting on top of a gold mine, but I don't mean actual gold.
We are now on top of Europe's by far largest deposit of rare earth elements.
It's the stuff that makes electric vehicles accelerate so fast, phone screens glow so bright, and missile systems so accurate. They're so important that having a secure supply of them is now part of European Union law. But today, the EU gets the vast majority of its rare earth elements from China. For some rare earths, that's 100%, and that's starting to feel like a pretty big problem.
We have more a sense of urgency than we had before.
If this mine gets going, it would become Europe's first internal source of rare earth elements. But to get to this hidden treasure, they'll have to get underneath a village of over 2,000 people, and they've got a pretty crazy plan for how to do it. Can it work? About a two-hour drive from Norway's capital Oslo is Ulefoss, one of Europe's oldest industrial communities. People have been mining iron here since the 1600s, until the last mining project shut down in the 1960s.
Ulefoss is a mining community without a mine. Growing up in Ulefoss, many people have said that one day there will be new mining activity. We just don't know when.
That's Tord Espen Simonsen. He's the community go-between for Rare Earths Norway, which owns 90% of the mining rights for the ancient mineral deposit here, known as Fen.
If we go 580 million years back in time, we will now be standing inside of a volcano. The Norwegian geologist Brøgger described this area for the first time in the 1920s and discovered that this was a limestone volcano.
And this discovery could change the fate of the region today, because volcanic limestone rocks like the ones he discovered usually contain something special. Rare earth elements, a group of 17 metals that have become essential components of pretty much everything, from mobile phones to microchips to missile defense systems. Despite their name, they're actually pretty common. Tiny amounts can be found everywhere. But it only makes sense to extract them from areas with a really high concentration. And Rare Earths Norway thinks this is the right place to do it.
Everything that you see around you here is part of the Fen deposit. We are extracting 10,000 meters of core samples to better our understanding of the deposit and strengthen the quality of our resource estimate, telling us much more about the composition of the resources in the ground.
These samples from deep inside the old volcano give the company their first look at what they're working with.
These brown minerals here are the ore for rare earth elements. So in this specimen here, we have around 2 to 3% rare earth elements. And that is actually very good.
The company says they've got high concentrations of these specific rare earth elements, which are used to make the permanent magnets that go into wind turbines and EVs.
We are extracting a lot of information at this stage. And also we can put a number on the upcoming resource, on the value.
That number? Almost 9 million tons of rare earth oxides, which is less than the biggest deposits in China and the US, but much more than any other known deposit in Europe.
So this is the logging room.
And size isn't the only thing that matters. The company says this deposit has a lot of other advantages that make it stand out on the global stage. Fen has easy access to clean energy from the local hydropower plant. And it's only 30 kilometers from Herøya, which has both a deep water port, connecting it to the global market, and Europe's first rare earth elements separation plant, RETEC. But just because it's big and well connected, doesn't mean it'll be quick or easy to get out of the ground. And the company still has a lot to learn about what's actually inside Fen. This old mine, which just happens to border the deposit, gives them the chance to do that. Tord Espen says the company is beginning a pilot operation next year, using this mine as an entry point to extract 6,000 tons of rare earth ore and processing that in a pilot factory.
This old closed mine will not be a part of the future operation, but it is important to just have the feeling of being inside of the Fen deposit. You can feel it when you are in this room, that we are underneath the living areas on top of us, and we can almost smell the rare earth elements further down the tunnel.
What he calls living areas are the company's big problem. Like many of the world's biggest rare earth mines, The Fen deposit is really close to the surface, beginning only about 100 metres below. But pretty much all of those mines look like this. Open pits which extract the biggest possible yield, but completely destroy everything on the surface. So for Ulefoss to survive, they'll have to go under it instead. And the company has a plan to still get as much out of this deposit as they possibly can, without affecting the people only a few hundred metres above. The idea is to create an invisible mine, the first of its kind in the world. Starting about 4 kilometres away, they'll drill a long, narrow tunnel diagonally into the heart of the deposit. Then, using automated drills, they'll dig out giant 300 by 50 metre sections of the deposit. That material is dropped into a crusher right below, and once pulverised, it's all sent up on conveyor belts to be separated at the processing site. But that still leaves giant holes underneath the town, and that can create some serious problems. In 2004, the Swedish mining company LKAB informed the city of Kiruna that their nearby underground iron mine was slowly causing the earth's surface to sink, crack, and collapse. To keep the city alive, they began relocating over 6,000 residents, moving the town centre 3 kilometres away. And a 2020 earthquake triggered by the mining activity there hasn't helped the reputation of underground mining either. So to avoid this, the company plans to send most of the waste material back down, filling in the holes they were extracted from, mixed with cement, to strengthen the rock enough to avoid the same problems faced by Kiruna. If all goes to plan, it'll be like nothing was removed at all. An invisible mine. But despite the company's promises, the people that live here must be completely opposed to the idea of a mine being dug underneath their homes, right? Well, no. A lot of them are actually really excited about it.
Well, it's something I've grown up with, hearing the histories of the mining community. And now that the history repeats itself, possibly, that's exciting.
At the local school, which Rohwer-Kahlmann Norway hopes to hire a lot of its future workforce from, the idea of mining coming back to this old mining town is pretty appealing. The company says it's signed agreements with the school and local businesses in Ulefoss to involve students and residents in the pilot mine next year.
It's a big operation, so it's exciting to watch on the news and see what's going to happen.
But some residents say there are still a lot of unanswered questions.
There's some people that are have seen things from other places, like they're scared that our houses are going to fall down in a big crater, or something is going to be destroyed, or if it's going to be a lot of noise or stuff like that.
There's also the issue of the tailings that aren't sent back down into the mine. Dealing with waste material is something every mining project worldwide has to face. But some residents are concerned about the nearby lakes that'll be used to store these tailings. The company says that these lakes would be reworked with membranes to ensure that any runoff is purified. And these concerns don't seem to be a deal breaker for the residents here. A 2023 survey found 80% in favour, with only 3% opposed.
This place has been important in the past, and it's kind of cool that it's important right now, this little place in Norway.
But it's not just the people here who think it's important. The Fen project is setting up right as the EU rushes to secure an internal supply of critical materials. While Norway isn't a part of the EU, it's a close ally with strong trading ties.
We are far behind, and I think both in the EU and of course in Norway and other European countries, we see that we are vulnerable.
That's Thomas Norvoll. He's the State Secretary of the Norwegian Ministry, responsible for the mining sector, including approving projects like Fen.
There is a fright that we can be locked out from supply chains.
Those supply chains, from extraction to separation to processing and manufacturing, are all completely dominated by China. That means the EU imports basically all of its rare earth magnets from there. And that sounds a lot like another pickle the bloc found itself in recently. Until 2022, Europe relied heavily on imported Russian gas to power their industry and heat their homes, because it was cheaper than producing it themselves. After Russia's invasion of Ukraine, the bloc had to go through the painful process of finding different and more secure sources. But China's dominance of the entire rare earth supply chain makes it harder for Europe to compete at every stage of the process, let alone trying to build the whole thing from scratch.
One thing that is difficult in this industry, of course, is that you have to invest a lot very early, and you get the incomes many years later. So you have to have some kind of endurance when you go into it. So therefore, of course, what we can do is to be there in the very beginning and make the first process as easy as possible.
And in 2024, Europe made a plan to do that. It's called the Critical Raw Materials Act, and it sets non-binding targets for how much critical materials the EU should produce itself by 2030. To get there as fast as it can, the Act lets the EU designate strategic projects, both within the EU and with close allies like Norway. This is basically a stamp of approval, giving the project more access to funding and wider public acceptance. But most importantly, it puts them on a fast-track list, making it quicker and easier to get the approvals and permits needed to get the project up and running. For Rare Earths Norway, this could be life or death.
It's like a window of opportunity. For every hour we are working with this project, it costs a lot of money. We cannot be just investigating for 10 years.
But even if Rare Earths Norway gets this tick of approval, there's still a long way to go before the rare earth gold mine underneath Fen can see the light of day. The company hopes to start operations by 2035, scaling up to meet 30% of the EU's demand by 2050. And while Fen is the biggest deposit in Europe that we know of, there are other alternatives that the EU is looking into in the meantime. Greenland, an independent territory of Denmark, has very large amounts of rare earths. But getting to them is very difficult, especially since the US now wants them as well. So for now, the people in Ulefoss feel like their new mine will have a pretty big role to play.
I hope that's gonna make a better situation for our continent in the future.
So how would you feel if there was a mine being drilled underneath your home? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe and check out dw.com for more stories like this.